So, this slot in the MariaDB server MiniFest December 2020 edition is an interview with Kamalakannan Annathurai from DBS Bank in Singapore. Hi, Kamal, and welcome.
Hi, thank you. Thank you for inviting us. Good to see the MiniFest during this COVID situation. Thank you.
Yes, indeed. So, the topic for our MariaDB server MiniFest continues to be MariaDB's release policy. It's not about functionality, it's about major and minor releases and how often we release them and how often our users pick the releases and decide about their upgrade policies. So Kamal, can you briefly describe the platform, including the machines and the operating systems where DBS Bank applies MariaDB?
Okay. MariaDB now, our environment mostly it's in Linux, it's Red Hat Linux. We have Linux in multiple platforms. It can be physical, it can be VPC, our virtual private cloud or VMware farm, but it's all in under Linux OS.
Okay. And as for the infrastructure still, what kind of high availability software and perhaps hardware are used to achieve HA?
Okay, software-wise, we rely on the MariaDB Max scale for high availability. On hardware and the platform-wise, we have the VMware farm. So VMware handles fully. If there is a failure or any issue with the server, VMware vMotions to the different pod or different data center also. We have a data center active. Mm-hmm. So even if the whole data center goes down, VMware manages it. So we have multiple levels of HA.
And what about like replication and Galera and all of that? I mean, you mentioned Max scale, but what about replication?
Replication, we have the master slave replication. For most of the cases, we used to have one slave, but for some scenario, we have two slaves. So all the write operation goes to the master. If I want to generate the reports and all, read operation goes to one of the slave. Mm-hmm. So for the very critical applications, we have one master and two slave.
Okay. So then, remember that we're talking now about major and minor server versions, but basically the first fundamental question is which server version are you on and how long have you been so?
Okay, we started this journey in 2015, right? We came into MariaDB. We started with 10.1. Then the most stable version for us is 10.2. Then every year we have a new major upgrade. We have some servers in 10.3 and 10.4. We are eagerly waiting for 10.5. Just last month, our POC testing all went fine in 10.5. We have started upgrading to 10.5. So our versions are spread across 10.2, 10.3, and 10.4. But our plan is now move everything to 10.5 in next 6 months.
Interesting. Yes. So this means then that a couple of applications are on one release and another set of applications are on another major release, if I understand you correctly.
Yeah.
Okay, so what then happens inside the major releases? Let's say that we're talking about an application on 10.3. Do you upgrade that 10.3 for point releases, for minor releases? And if so, how frequently?
Okay, we see what is covered in that minor release. If there is security fix, we apply immediately. It will be in next 1 or 2 months. But if the minor release covers some features enhancements, and if it is required for us, we push ahead. Else, we bundle it into the major release upgrade.
Makes sense to me. So another detailed question on that. Let's say that you have a bug in one application, but not in the other one. Both are on 10.3, and because of that one application, you upgrade MariaDB 10.3 for that one. Would you then always do the upgrade for the other ones as well using 10.3? So do you have just across the board one major release for all the apps running it?
Yes, we will migrate. Since we have thousands of databases, we cannot do it in weeks or months.
Yeah.
The complete cycle takes at least 9 months to 12 months. But by end of the year, all the servers will be in the latest minor release.
Mm-hmm. So you evidently have several major releases at the same time. So as I hear you, you want to go to 10.5 as quickly as you can. But what does the decision process look like? I mean, what goes on in your evaluation process when you upgrade?
Mainly it is features on the performance. 10.5 has a lot of features for us, which we are asking you, Monty, Michael Howard and all. We have the very important feature, the object store compatibility. Then the new engine in 10.5, the InnoDB engine and the column store engine, performance is very good. Based on our initial POC, performance has improved at least 3 times. Then additionally, there are a lot of features. We can have in earlier versions, we can have decimal points up to 18 digits. Now it is increasing to 48 and all. Likewise, then the backup, initially in the 10.1, 10.2 and all, backup used to lock the tables. Now the recent releases backup has improved a lot. It is no lock-free backup. So we go based on the features we have. Since 10.5 has a lot of important features which we are waiting for a while, that's why we are pushing everything to 10.5 now.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense. So you're driven a lot by the functionality and the performance and all of that. Makes sense. So you were saying you're doing proof of concept. So you need, of course, also to gain confidence in the stability. So what's your testing process like for a new major release?
We have thousands of databases running in MariaDB. We will select few databases, a few in OLTP, the online transaction processing, few on the OLAP analytical processing, few more on the report generation, heavy batch processing. We select these different kind of databases. We run one round of regression testing in all kinds of databases. When all goes fine for this pilot testing, then we move ahead with the actual migrations.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So one question that I'm always curious about for everybody using MariaDB, it's the stability and the balance between stability and the new functionality, because obviously everybody would want both, as stable as possible, no bugs and good performance, but also people need new functionality. So what's your view of the balance that MariaDB is striking between fixing bugs and improving stability and adding new functionality?
I think over the years, MariaDB has matured a lot. We are in MariaDB for the last 5 years, from 2015 till 20. Every year, our growth is almost a double tripling. Reason is it is stable. It is highly stable. Performance improving in every version. This is the main. What is the third point you are asking? How you balance?
Well, balance between new functionality. Like, let's say that we're now contemplating: should we put? We have, of course, everybody has limited resources, and so does MariaDB. Should MariaDB put those limited? How should we distribute those limited resources? More towards new functionality, or more towards fixing any remaining issues?
I don't see any issues recently. If we see the cases Jira raised with MariaDB, issues are very less recently. Recently means it's since last year also, we can say. Instead, our request more coming towards the new features. Example, we were asking for the Kafka integration for a while. Earlier, we used to use a third-party tool to pick the data changes and inject into the other environments. Now, since we have Kafka integrator, whatever the changes happening in database, in real time, we can able to stream the data. So now it's the performance and new features driving more.
Mm-hmm. Good to know. So when thinking about the release policy, I think one quickly comes to the question about what quality really is. And the quality is, everybody thinks quality is a good thing to strive for, but people use this word without really defining what they mean. So what constitutes quality from your perspective? What is your sort of definition of how MariaDB server quality should be looked upon? And then the follow-up question is, how does MariaDB fulfill that definition? But first, please, what does quality mean to you?
Okay. Earlier question I was answering, right? This OLTP, OLAP, and different kind of platforms. Whenever I get a new major or minor release, when I do the testing, if the regression passes fully, quality is good for me. This is the first thing. Mm-hmm. Second, ours is a financial institution. So we are always demanding. So always there is scope for improvement. We always push your guys to improve more and more. That is better for us, better for you, better for everyone.
Mm-hmm. Good. So I'm then looking at like the cadence, the frequency of updates. And I'm looking at the frequency of updates both for the major releases, which is once a year, and the frequency of the minor releases, which now has started to converge to be once every 3 months. So what's your view on that frequency? Is it too rare? Is it too often? Is it just about right?
This is the right decision, I think. Even the other major industry players also doing this way only. Major release should be every year. Minor release earlier, depending on the urgency, sometimes we used to have releases in between also, but quarterly minor release is best.
Mm-hmm.
But some of the industry leaders, they still do 2 years once or 3 years once. But in this fast changing world, in our lot of requirements, waiting for 2-3 years for a release is too long.
Yeah, so
when we need something new feature, new enhancement, the major release every year is best. That's what I feel.
So one of the consequences of too slow release cycles is the need for backporting. So we have a number of users of MariaDB who don't want to upgrade. They are on, let's say, 10.3, and they know that 10.4 has, or 10.5 has functionality that they would like to have, but for some reason they would rather not rock the boat. They would want 10.3 to contain this one single feature that they really urge for. So they would want that to be backported. So what's your thinking about, under what conditions do you think we can and should backport new features to old releases, or is that the wrong way to go? Should you just say no to backporting and instead upgrade to the latest version?
My view is backporting should be avoided. In a way, if we are backporting everything, means that already becomes the latest N version. Instead, we can upgrade.
That was a very, very clear statement. So another area where I think there's a gray zone is when we have a particular release. Let's say now we are on 10.5.8, and then there's a fix to something, but it's not like a security bug or a crashing bug where it's really, really clear that it is a bug and not a feature. Let's say it's a specification which was sloppy before and a crucial missing functionality or anything which points out the fact that the borderline between a bug and a bug fix and a feature is a bit of a gray zone. So how do you look upon that? Where should we draw the line when it comes to fixing stuff that can be either portrayed as a bug fix or as a new feature?
For me, even though you say it's a bit closer, what I feel is we should be able to draw a clear line. If my application, if my database is running fine in production, if it breaks, then it is a bug. That one has to be fixed very fast.
Yeah.
But if I need some new feature, then we cannot categorize it as a bug. If nothing is breaking my production, then those all can be parked under enhancement new features.
Okay, so that makes sense, but you're not the only user of, say, 10.5. Let's say that your application is not crashing, yours is doing just fine, but there's another user who cannot use 10.5 because of some crucial thing that they think it's a bug. You might think it's a feature. So the line of thinking here would be that as long as you are not disturbed by the change, it should be fine to fix what the other user considers to be a bug. Do you subscribe to that reasoning?
It's not me or the database. It can be any database across the companies. If a running live database, if it breaks, then we can consider it as a bug. Mm-hmm. Whether I may be using that feature, I may not be using. If I use that feature, I may hit the bug. If I don't use the feature, I may not hit the bug. But the other user may be using that feature, they will hit the bug. Those things we can call it as a bug. But if the database is not live, it is not failing in a live environment, then those all can be bugged under enhancement, new features.
I think you're very efficient in shedding, putting light on those gray zones and telling us that they're not that gray after all. So that's very good. Any wishes when it comes to the release schedule and the quality from DBS Bank's side?
Release schedule, we are fine. Major release every year, minor releases quarterly. That is good. For quality, as I said earlier, there is always scope for improvement. We should keep on improving further. Over the years, I have seen that improvement also. I told, right, we are the user for last 5 years. We have an enterprise license agreement with you. Every year, we host Monty in Singapore for our MariaDB conference. Then I have visited the US office also. So we are working closely, we are partners. So everything is good, but this partnership helps us to improve the quality also. It is improving steadily.
Any further messages related to the release policy or something I forgot to ask you?
For release policy, we have covered everything. It is good, but I would like to see MariaDB, compared to other industry players, we can do much better in entering many industries, say finance or medical or universities. Or MariaDB should. I like to see MariaDB extends further with so much capability features compared with all the industry major databases. MariaDB should be moving much faster.
Great. Kamalakannan Annathurai, thank you very much for your views and your description of MariaDB at DBS Bank in Singapore. Thank you, Kamal.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks for hosting this interview.